What up, y'all? How y'all doing? This week is gonna be epic. Hey, it is so great to see all of you, even though you can only see me, I can't really see you, but, you know, who gives a crap? It is great to be back with another episode of the vlog. I can barely keep up with the once a month thing. There's been so much going on in my life, so just give me just 2 seconds here. So, again, let's get down to business. Oh my gosh. So, funny thing is, I'm filming this, recording this at the time that Kelsey took off and is out of town at the moment. So I'm here all alone. Just us. And what's going on here? And, I think I may have stated the last episode, there's a lot of things going on in my life currently, a lot of things on the go. So this vlog has turned more into what's going on in my personal life, what's going on in my everyday, versus being more focused on work and stuff like that. So less about work and more about me, and Kelsey and what's going on with us and what we're doing. So I'm actually going to get into a little something actually a little bit later, but before we do that, there's a lot of things I got to get done. Tonight we are recording another episode of the podcast, the Elevate Podcast. If you haven't been watching, well, I'm going to take this opportunity to plug my podcast on this platform. Go listen to it on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Anchor, and all any other podcatcher you listen to. It's been great. If you are interested in design, business, marketing, any of those things, we get into all of those things, but not so much in the design lately, but tonight that changes. So looking forward to getting that recorded and having that out by next week. I'm just speaking a million miles a minute right now. So that's kind of what's going on. So I'm gonna actually take you over. I'm going to take my, actually, cause you know, Kelsey took the car with her. So I'm without car in a house, and I actually haven't left my neighborhood in the past 3 days. So it's gonna be good to get on a bike and get into Halifax here. I'm biking on in and see how that goes, and meet up with Dalton or do some recording. But then after that, I have a story to tell all of you that I've been meaning to tell you, just haven't got around to it. So let's go.
Hey, Don.
What's up, BB?
Come on, dog.
Oh, I was gonna say.
You too, bro. I don't know.
Yeah, boys, babies, all of you. We made it. We biked in, got some calories off the old stomach all right there. And here my boy Dalton about to start the old podcast-a-reno today. And I'm looking forward to, we're gonna talk some UX today, we'll talk some design. Talk some other things Dalton's writing down at the moment. So we're excited for that. But as well as, I'm looking forward to just getting this recorded. Then we'll get into the story that I was telling you guys about earlier. All right, it's been an awesome day. It's been an awesome week so far, but we land here on Friday. And it's finally time. I can finally tell you the story I've been wanting to tell you. So, wanted to take the rest of this time of the vlog to kind of go into the story of what happened to myself and Kelsey. So I'll start off with this. You know, we're still going through this COVID stuff and all this craziness. And, you know, sometimes I'm sure we're all feeling it right now, right? We all want to get away. Some of us have done so. We've gone to cottages that are within our province or our state, wherever we're watching this. We want to go to somewhere that, you know, isn't, you know, our house. We want to go try something. So
We specifically those who live in the northern states, people who live in Canada, you know, a lot of us feel this as well come the winter time. You know, Kelsey is an avid skier and loves skiing. I try to ski. And we really wanted to start making it a habit through our winters to, you know, get out to ski like 3-4 times in a season. As a weekend away, we decided, you know what, we want to rent an Airbnb. And, you know, rent an Airbnb, hang out, relax, enjoy our time, sleep there, get up in the morning, go skiing, come back, relax, and eat, drink some hot chocolate, do what we gotta do, and just enjoy our time that isn't here in Halifax. So this is what we wanted to do. This is our trip. And, well, suffice to say, it didn't exactly go according to plan. We did pick a really sweet Airbnb spot. It was sweet! It was out in the middle of nowhere. You had to kind of take, you know, windy roads to get out to it. We were literally out on a lake. It was pristine. It was beautiful time. It was gonna be a great time away as a married couple. We get there and we got a Toyota Corolla. We're cruising. And we kind of winding. And then we have to take a left to get up to take the road to go up to our cottage or where we were staying at the time. And we come down like a slight incline and then we got to crank a left at 90 degrees. And then we realize rest of the street, it is just a hill and it's all ice. Let's just say our car didn't make it up and we crashed into a snowbank. What we ended up finding out is after we crashed into the snowbank, our brake lines completely went and our car was stuck up on a snowbank. That sucked. So we are in the middle of nowhere. Our car is stuck up on a snowbank. We're still probably about a 6-7 minute walk away from our Airbnb. And our car has no more brakes on it. So we did the best we could do for the night that we had there. But this is the rest of the story that took place. All right, so we're out here at our Airbnb, which is a nice spot. It's a pretty good pad over here. We didn't get to enjoy it for long as our car is in a ditch at the bottom of the hill all the way from here because it slid off. And we're gonna explain the whole thing leading up to it as we walk down the hill to go retrieve our car so that CEA can tow it to Amherst to get it fixed. It's Kelsey contemplating her fate.
Pretty much.
She thinks we're gonna be stuck here. With no food.
With some peanuts and apples.
That's the problem. We actually have no food. We literally are in the middle of nowhere. I think we are
about 40 minutes from a Tim Hortons.
Yeah.
Which is like the worst of the worst.
The closest city is probably about 30 minutes away in Tatamagoosh. That's where our tow truck is coming from. And but we are probably the only people within probably a 5 or 6 kilometer radius of ourselves. So this is how the horror movies start, folks. But we made it through the night. That's what matters.
And we're sticking together.
Yeah.
Not separating.
Not separating. It's gonna be lit, folks. So can you fill the homies in what our mission is?
Okay, so I get, I'm not convinced that this should be our mission, but our mission is to move the car to the main road, which is still covered in ice, so that the tow truck is more likely to come save us.
Yeah, there you go. And this is a key to a reminder. It's like, it's not just like, the problem with the car is there's just no brakes on it. The brakes are gone. So we're gonna try and maneuver a car on a windy, icy road out to the more main road so the tow truck can get us more safely. I think we can do it.
I'm not sure we should.
I think we should. You see that snow out there, folks? It's only getting worse. See, it's a skating pond over here. The whole thing is just pure ice. It's like this all the way down this road. And we've lugging ourselves. We're all looking like a huge caravan. Like rented mules.
There's minimal sand on the road. It's a spicy time, what can I say? And we're about a 4-5 minute walk from where our car slid into the ditch. So we're just making our way down there now and try to get this car out to the main road so we can have a more safe tow. You know, so that's the goal of all this is. And we're a little, you know, as you can tell, it's slipping and sliding all the time. And I'm trying my best to not die too. And she got boots, I got sneakers, so this is jokes. But you can see, like, there's houses and stuff over here, but there's no one in them right now. Like, those are just pure summer homes, so they're really out here. Fully out here, boys. And so, talking to the car. Hill that we couldn't get up last night. It's really interesting, because, like, there's no real reason we shouldn't have gone up it, because there's a good amount of sand on it. But it is, obviously, you can tell, very icy. I think if we got up to this point, we would have made it up. But at the bottom is just where it's super icy. We just couldn't get up. So there's our car, obviously, right there that we just left for the night. And minimal damage. As you can tell from the photos, I showed you, like, we slid right into that sucker over here. And you can see the tire tracks. We just barely missed that tree. Like, it was the Lord himself. You know, so we got it out, rocked it enough. And minimal damage on it, just lucky. And now we're gonna do our best to try and get this sucker out of here with no brakes. All right, you ready? You ready? Not yet. All right, get it ready. Oh, shoot.
Now this is where we put the car into neutral. And I was like, wait a second, I can't put this in neutral. All right, I gotta put this in drive. So I put the car in drive. Kelsey stayed behind just in case we couldn't get up the hill, which in hindsight was probably a bad idea. This is us. We revved up the car and here we go. We start rolling, we're rocking, we're rolling, we're rocking, and we're rolling. I'm obviously freaking out at this point, but it looks like we pull it off.
Oh, baby, we did it.
I take the phone. I want to film this moment. Kelsey's behind the car, making sure everything's good. I'm chilling, steering. Trying my best, looking down. And this is just, you know, an absolute gong show. I'm still trying to wind my way through these streets with no brakes. Only an emergency brake. So make sure I don't go too fast. All I got is a gas pedal. And we're cruising, and we're rocking, and we're rolling. We finally got to where we need the car to be put. I had to check the mirrors 1 second. Look back at you guys, because I love you guys. Look at the rear mirror, make sure Kelsey's okay. And yeah.
All right, well, we made it. We got to the main road. Eat that, suckers.
We didn't hit any trees.
Oh, yeah. Hey, we did it.
We did it.
Right. We did it. She didn't believe.
I didn't.
But we did it. And now I just got a call from the truck guy, so he actually will probably be here in the next 15 minutes or so. So we are pumped. Let's go. She didn't know that. Let's go. So that's, we're gonna keep things updated and meet our trucker Dave. I don't know what his name is, but we'll find out. So here we go.
Here we go.
Saved us. Very appreciative. On our way to Amherst. But hopefully it's not too bad of a fix. And then we can get on home and get Kelsey to work tomorrow. So let's go.
And that is how it all shook out. Again, pretty brief for the most part. Interesting details. A little bit wild. A little bit of fun. A little bit of drama. And we all love little doggo Jenny. I was excited to be able to finally share that with you. That's been in the vault for a while at this point. And it was, what can I say? Experiences, trauma, and fun create great character, don't they? So anyways, thank you so much for tuning in one more time. Super grateful for it. Gonna keep trying to get back in the mode of doing this on a monthly basis to keep you updated on what's happening over here. And again, very grateful for your time. So, have yourselves a great week. And as for me, well, I'm out.